think that in the last 20, 30 years, the environment today is much more conducive than it ever was for entrepreneurs to come and do their work. And why do I say that? Because there are certain inherent barriers, at least in the industry I have operated in, which is FMCG, which are lesser today, far lesser than what they were earlier. For example, one obvious one is the funding part. I mean, earlier, entrepreneur would never get funding. Today, thanks to VCs and investors, that is a very, very reasonably easy task. Number two came the manufacturing part. Now, you don't need to set up your own factories. Because the FMCG landscape has exploded in the last few years across food categories, you have more than enough third-party manufacturers. You don't need to go and invest behind your own manufacturing. Then the third part, which always came, is distribution. Because companies like Unilever or whatever, I mean, even us ITC, we have built our own distribution systems, reaching out to 4 million, 5 million household outlets across 100 years or 50 years. And that can't be replicated. But today, thanks to e-com, thanks to modern trade, all of that is easily available to an entrepreneur. Plus, I believe today you also have companies which are helping a group of entrepreneurs to actually distribute in mom-and-pop stores, or at least in kirana stores. So all of that is coming together, which is why obviously you and I see so many entrepreneurs coming up and so many new products getting launched, which are very, very good. Now, coming to some of the learnings here, I think I will dwell on also the point because I know that your organization, NICE, is doing some very, very commendable work in the area of how we can use the Indian products, Indian understanding to actually create entrepreneurship and successful entrepreneurship. I'll give you an example of, for example, one of the categories we have in ITC, which is the juices market.
Right.
Now, the Tetra Pak juices market where we operate in, basically, obviously, it's a large market. It's dominated by many, many large local and global players. However, when we entered the market, we said that the differentiation is very, very low because it's a Tetra Pak juice is a Tetra Pak juice. And that is a reality for the consumer. But we also said that how can we differentiate? Now, there are two things which we thought of. One is that, I mean, ITC is a company which I think very much thinks like NICE because, I mean, ITC always believes in that we're a 107-year-old company. And we always believe that it should always work for the Indian consumer, for the Indian environment, and for the Indian economy. So basically, we said that if we study the current juice market, the reality is that most of the food juices that our families and our children are buying and consuming right now, they are made from concentrates imported from Europe or US or Brazil.
Right.
So what is concentrate is basically a powder. So you cannot move a fruit. It is damn expensive to get a fruit from California, an orange. So you basically take the juice, you heat it to extreme temperature, it becomes powder. You pack the powder, 1 year shelf life, you take it to India. You pack in Tetra Pak, you heat it with water, and you pack it with flavor, etc., into a Tetra Pak. That is how the juice market for most flavors is constructed across India by most players. We said, no, let us think how we can change that. We said, first thing is that the inherent nutrition of fruits is better if the juice is fresher rather than through a powder route. Number two, we also said that that will also help the Indian farmer because, as PM Modi has said, that you have to. India is the second largest grower of fruits and vegetables. But a lot of it is wasted, as you know, because of lack of cold storage, because of lack of table fruit ecosystem, etc., etc. So we said we should also be promoting that. So we have created, ITC has created in the last 3 years, a large ecosystem where we have created pulping and farmer linkages of fruits which are never put in juices in India earlier, like pineapple from Kerala or apple from Himachal or Nagpur orange. And we are the only juice brand where all our 12 variants, which we sell, not a single piece of concentrate is there, and not a single piece of imported fruit is there. It's all fruit of Indian farmers. And we're very proud of that. So that has helped us to also communicate. Because what also happens is that when you use a fresh fruit, the inherent nutrition value, which is why you or I have a fruit juice or have a fruit, is better than when you concentrate something from outside and you heat it and you bring it here. So that's a proposition we have made, saying not from concentrate. So we've tried to basically use that as our USP and also as our differentiator and also try to do something better for the farmer.